All right, it is time to do John Lennon's Imagine. If this song takes long enough to teach in order to bump a few songs out of here and make it a shorter video, so be it. It just has to be here. It happened on Campfire 9. A couple of them took a while to teach. This is going to be one of those, and it's important enough to do so. As you all realize, this song is 100% piano, so we get to do it 100% guitar. So to make passable chords and still make the song recognizable, I've figured a way. So we all know the intro, and you can do the bird parts or whatever you want to do with it. Those parts are easy. You just kind of go. Okay, so check out the intro, which is coming up right now. Okay, so now what we're going to do there is this. And I'll teach you all the other chords in a second. But basically all this is C, C major 7, and F, as far as the way we're going to play it. Of course, pianos are voiced so differently. So what we're going to do is... I'll do it better this time. Yeah, I'm getting it. But in order to get all of these chords in and to get the little lick in, which is a must, I had to put it on the lower register. Okay, so we're doing just a straight C chord. There's C major 7, it's simply lifting off your first finger of the C chord. Okay, so we're just going up on the C, starting on the B string. Okay, so C up in the C note. Open it up to C major 7, then F. Okay, so what this is, again, C, C, C major 7, just lift up the one finger right before you go to F. Then we have open A string to 2 to 3, those are the frets. Then you make your C chord again, but you have to make it differently. You have to use your pinky where that was, because you have to put your ring finger up here on the G note. Okay, so third fret of the low E string. So now you're covering still the C chord, but with your pinky, but you're putting this one right on top. So it won't get too unfamiliar feeling after you do it just a few times, just like you saw. I warmed up to it, you know, too. And it takes a little getting used to. So. Okay, and you'll notice the more you slop it together, the more it will sound good. Okay, so that's the main riff all the way through the majority of the verses. Okay. the big deal, is that. And then, doing that C major 7 by lifting the one finger. Okay, so that will be the majority of our verses. The only weird chord in here, okay, other than those chords, I'm looking through, we're going to have just your typical F, of course, the A minor, then we do what's called a D minor 7. All that is an F chord, and you lift up that finger. You lift the finger off of the D string, and you go ahead and play the A string and the D string and everything except for the low E. Okay, so we go F. C. Then we go G. Okay, and there's going to be a G with a B bass in here. So it'll be G, you know, with the two fingers here for the G. And then just concentrate more on hitting the bass, being the B note instead of the G note the second time. So G, then B. Okay, so you're just playing that part of it. So the second fret of the A string. So G, then G with the B bass. So you're just shutting up the low string is all you're doing. And let's see, after that we have just a G7. So this one. So a regular G chord, but backwards, so it looks more like a C. So we just have our beginnings of a regular G, but we have our first finger on the first fret of the first string. Okay? And that is it as far as the chords go. That's just a matter of keeping them in line. One thing you'll never see on any sheet thing is right in the middle, it's a little thing that goes where it just stops and then goes. You probably never noticed it, but you'll see it. So I'm going to be yelling the chords out to you. And again, just remember the playing that very clearly is crucial. Okay, so let's go through it as many times as we have to. And I'll throw the chords by you. Again, those are the only chords during the verse. But the second half of the verse, we go to the F. If you want to write this down, please do. Okay, so it just does C, C major 7, F, do-do-do-do-do. It does that whole part three times, every single verse. Then it goes to F, to A minor, to D minor 7. That's the one where it just looks like an F, but you take your ring finger off. Then C. Then it goes right to the G with the B in the bass, then after that. And then G7. Then back to now, if you want to write this down so you can have it for later, this will be very important, so might as well write it down. The chorus, which it does twice, goes F, G, C. Okay, what this does, F to G. Now we do a C, then go down to the second. It sounds like it's getting ready to walk down to A minor, but it walks down to E minor. So it goes C, then we go to a B note, then we go to E7. So you do E, and put your pinky on the third fret of the second string, or your B string. So you just play E chord with a 7, so it's just E7. Okay, so it does that three times in a row. F, and G, and C. G and C, and again F and G and C, then F and G and C, then right there after the first chorus, That will actually be open A, then your A on your G string, so your second fret, then second fret on the A string, fourth fret on the G string, so two B notes, so A, A, B, and then back up to C. Okay, you'll hear it when it comes, okay? So let's just go from the beginning, check it out. All right, here we go. And we got about 5 seconds. And about 3, 2, 1. F, now our lick. Thing looks like an F. Okay, that's where it went by really quickly. Okay, so that goes by really quickly when it goes. See. G, B, bass. Okay, and then it goes by really quick. So when it goes to the F, A minor, D minor 7. B bass, then G7, okay, so let's go back and grab that part. Okay, here we go to the F, A minor, the D minor 7 thing, C, G, B bass, G minor, G7, and back to the C. Okay, one more time. Way back there. F, A minor. Okay, let me get right behind it one more time for you. Give you more of a run into it. Okay, here we go to the F. F, A minor, D minor 7. C, G, B bass, G7. Get back to the regular stuff. F, another lick, C major 7, F, and the same thing. Now the same thing we did before with the F, A minor, D minor 7, C, and G. The B bass, G7, here comes the chorus, F, G, and C, walk down E7, F, G, to C, walk it down, E7, F, G, to C, walk it down again, to E7, then F, G, now C. Okay, there's that little thing, the little piano riff. Listen for it. Okay. Listen. So that's it. Now let's grab that. Let's go back and get the chorus and then we'll go right through that whole part. Okay, so back a little. Here comes the chorus and F. And G, and C, walking down to the E, my E7, again, F, G, C to E7, F, G, C down to E7, F, and G, and C. Now the A, B thing. Now back to what we were doing. Thank you. D minor 7th thing, C, G, with the B bass, G7, chorus to the F, G, C, walk out of the E7, same thing, F, G, C to E7, F, G, C, E7, and F, and G, and C. Okay. So it didn't take quite as long as I thought. Okay, so please write that down. Okay? I know I don't have the fancy technology to be able to put words and tabs and all that junk on my screens. And do I apologize for it? No. Write it down. No biggie. Yeah, I do it the old school way because I'm old and it's just better this way. Okay, so again, you've got the beginnings. Second half of the verses is F, A minor, then the D minor 7, which is just a D chord, I'm sorry, an F chord, but with your ring finger taken off, and you hit the A string also, so you hit everything except for the low E. Then you just go to C, then we go to G, then the B in the bass, then G7. That's how you gotta write down again. F, A minor, D minor 7, C, then G, B, with the B in the bass, then G7, then we're right back to the beginning. Just back to that and a whole other verse with that same when we finally end on the G7. The chorus again is F, G, then C, walk down, E7. You do that three times. Then we do F, G, then C, then back to the verse. Okay? And it does the same chorus the second time, but instead of go into the boom da boom ba, you just end on the C and it's over. So that is it. Okay? So no more instruction needed. It's that cool. I think I broke it down easy enough with a... You know, for having to do it on guitar instead of piano, that's the best version I could come up with for a... campfire version of the song, and I think it serves it well. So I'm going to let you guys play, and I hope you have your notes. If you don't, go back and write them, because that's all you get, kiddies. Okay? And I will count you in. We get to listen to the birds for a second. And we're coming in about 3, 2, 1.
Hello. Come on, you're breaking up the band, Yoko.
Okay, there you go. Imagine. It had to be done. Imagine that. So, hope you enjoyed the arrangement on that one. I like it, so I'll probably go ahead and pick up the tune and start doing it solo, because I like the arrangement, and what cooler way to do it than on a good old Flying V acoustic, man. That's the way it should be done. Okay, really. This great tune had to be on here, so hope you guys appreciate the fact that song's here. Okay, we'll get on to the next one and pick it up a little bit. What do you think? All right, catch you on the next one.